On completing this chapter, you will have an understanding of who issues a discharge order, how it is different from a voyage order, how a discharge order can imply many operational costs and strenuous effort and watches for a ship's entire crew over many days, what is the purpose of a pre-arrival navigation meeting and a pre-arrival cargo operations meeting, what are the main features of a tanker discharge and crude oil washing plan, what are the typical requirements of crude oil washing checklists, what are the typical pre-arrival checks conducted by different crew members. Who issues a discharge order? The discharge order is normally communicated to the vessel's master by email from the owner or operator or charterers. The discharge order is the basic information needed in order to prepare the vessel for discharge. For shuttle tankers with frequent port calls, the practical implications of a discharge order are of less concern compared with the ULCCs and VLCCs. The high frequency of port calls gives the shuttle tanker crew a large amount of experience and routine, and the port organization, agents, authorities, pilots and tugboat companies, know these ships and how they are operated. When a ULCC or VLCC loaded in the Middle East, for instance, is directed to the US Gulf for discharging, several demanding and costly activities are involved, such as 3 to 4 STS operations, some 80 to 100 nautical miles from shore, service launches and helicopter service for US Guard inspectors, cargo surveyors, agents, crew change, stores and provisions, and normally vetting inspectors from different oil majors. In addition, activation of the mandatory shore-based organization according to OPA 90 requirements, like Qualified Individual, or QI, and Oil Pollution Cleanup Organizations, etc. 3 to 4 STS operations are very demanding, both for personnel and equipment, as each lightering normally takes approximately 48 hours and runs continuously until the large tanker is empty. Between a voyage order and a discharge order received by the master, which one affects the chief officer or cargo officer more? A voyage order is an instruction from the owner or operator or charterers to the vessel's master about where the vessel shall sail after completion of a port call. The vessel needs some kind of instruction on where to sail. For instance, proceed to outer anchorage, drop anchor and wait for further order, or proceed to US Gulf for order, etc. The discharge order is the specific instruction to proceed to a port or terminal and discharge all or part of the cargo. As the cargo may be sold during the laden voyage, the discharge order may change as well. A discharge order from the charterers will, in addition to lots of information about receivers, bills of lading, etc., also include crude oil washing instruction and allowance for extra discharging time. Based on the discharge order, the discharge plan is worked out by the chief officer. What is the main purpose of the pre-arrival meeting conducted by the master? A pre-arrival meeting is performed in different ways, depending on the vessel's trade. The master normally conducts the meeting, and the main purpose of the meeting is to ensure that all officers and crew are acquainted with the time schedule and activities expected to take place during the port call. Through this time schedule framework, the risk assessments associated with each in-port activity and the ship's plan for mitigating each of those risks is communicated. Beside the main purpose of a port call, loading or discharging, other activities can be STS lightering, special security measurements, crew change, stores and provisions, bunkering, external technical service for the vessel's equipment, various external inspections, etc. The discharge plan is a comprehensive. The discharge plan is a comprehensive and detailed schedule that comprises a time bar, cargo specification, spreadsheet with details on cargo grades, quantity, and their distribution into the different cargo tanks. Further, the plan details line and valve systems and cargo pumps to be used, and estimated start and stop times for the different cargo pumps and vacuum strip system. This part of the discharge plan may vary depending on whether the reception facility and capacity is known. The discharge plan will normally be updated when the terminal information is known. The discharge plan also includes a detailed schedule for crude oil washing or cove. For detailed information on crude oil washing, see CBT number 0054. Finally, the discharge plan includes the ballast operation, taking on ballast by gravity and by ballast pumps, etc. The chief officer conducts a meeting with the junior officers, which are second and third officer, pumpman and boatswain, in due time prior to arrival. The purpose of this meeting is to have their acknowledgement of full understanding of the discharge plan. The second and third officer are responsible duty deck officers during discharge, and consequently need to be fully familiar with the vessel's cargo system. To assist them during the operation, they have the pumpman, who is a qualified technician, and responsible for maintaining the cargo equipment. In addition, they have the boatswain, who is the leader of the deck crew. A crude oil carrier that intends to carry out crude oil washing during the discharge operation needs to inform and obtain permission from the port authority and terminal prior to arrival. Although this formality is communicated by the master, the junior officers should be familiar with such requirements. The MARPOL Annex 1 Regulation 13.6 requires every new crude oil tanker of 20,000 deadweight tons and above to be fitted with a crude oil washing system and an approved crude oil washing manual. The crude oil washing manual contains a pre-arrival crude oil washing checklist, ship-specific, which should be completed by the chief officer prior to arrival at every discharge port where it is intended to undertake crude oil washing. The crude oil washing checklist is formed in three sections for use before, during, and after crude oil washing operations. The crude oil washing checklist is to be shown to the loading master during the ship or shore meeting and during the crude oil washing operation. Click on the buttons to find out more. Since the introduction and implementation of the International Safety Management Code, that is the ISM code, mandatory from 1998, ship owners or other companies responsible for operation of ships have had to develop and implement safety management systems, both for the ships and shore-based organization. The safety management objectives of the company should provide for safe practices in ship operation and systems to monitor and document onboard activities where needed. Checklists to document safe practices and compliances with rules and regulations, as well as the company's policy, have been developed and implemented as industry standard in connection with various operations on board. The pre-arrival checklist is a comprehensive record of preparations carried out in order to document that the vessel is arriving in a condition according to the company's policy and international rules and regulations. All junior officers, including pumpman and boatswain, as well as the engine officers and crew, will be engaged in testing and checks in order to complete the pre-arrival checklist. Engineer officers. Junior deck officers. Pumpman. Boatswain. Checklist and repairs of malfunctions. Click on the thumbnails to learn more. Engineer officers. In the engine, all the technical systems required by the checklist to be tested and the results reported back to the chief officer. These tests must include operation of the cargo and inert gas pipelines valve operating systems, hydraulic power packs or boilers for cargo pumps, inert gas systems, ballast and stripping pumps, and alarms and trips of all these. Junior deck officers. The junior officers are responsible for checking their designated equipment and systems, such as firefighting and life-saving equipment, navigational instrumentation, etc. Pumpman. The pumpman is responsible for function checking of all cargo equipment and cargo-related safety systems and equipment. Bosun. The bosun, with the deck crew, must check and prepare all mooring equipment, oil pollution prevention equipment, accommodation ladders, pilot ladders, hose handling cranes, deck scuppers, and assist the pumpman with preparation of the cargo manifolds to be used. Ample time for repairs of malfunctions. The checklist must be completed in ample time prior to arrival in order to allow for repairs of malfunctioning equipment, or call for external service upon arrival. Any negative answers in the checklist must be reported to the owner or operator in order to make a common effort to ensure the vessel's safe and efficient port call without any delays.